Hey guys, Jeff Bradshaw here from ElderlyIron.com with a little bit of Elderly Iron. Well, the rainy season is about upon us. And that means that once it starts raining, I'll be able to sit down at the editor, start posting some videos. In the meantime, if you remember this 63 Wagon, I've been trying to sell this car for 3 years. And nobody buying it. I had three different people asked me for parts off of it, so once the third person asked, and the fact that of all three people, they all still wanted the parts, and they all want different parts, I decided to bite the bullet on this one and take it apart. Well, it's getting to the point where every nut, bolt, and screw is becoming valuable on these things. So, I already broke this panel, getting this out of here, I wasn't too pleased about it. And basically, the whole reason I'm putting this video up is so the person who's getting these parts can take this apart and replace this tail light without busting up their interior panels. So we have a clip at 4 1/4, 13, 21 1/2. I'm never going to remember all that. Black marker. And come right off the window. Can't see the rest of them. Those are 8 1/2 inches apart. 8 1/2 inches apart. On 8 1/2 inch centers. 4 1/4 and then 8 1/2 inch centers.
You can see there how the panel fits onto it. So what I'm going to attempt to do is figure out a way to get those off there without breaking that panel. So I'm thinking putting a putty knife down in here and then forcing that back slightly, somewhat. They don't seem to want to bend any. Not with this flimsy putty knife. Okay, I need something better. The only problem is that panel bites into that thing. Right, here's the next one. Well, something wide and flat and stiff. In the toolbox is a brake spoon. Sure don't want to break that window though. Of course, when you put this back in, you gotta remember to bend these back up again. Well, let's see if it works on the next one. Purely an instructional video aimed at one person. I'll at least turn the rest of you junkies on to this. A shower of rust. Would you believe I'm actually going to try to save this?
Yep.
Step one. Lay it down on the floor.
For those of you who will be doing this job, you don't have to start with pulling the headliner. But you do need to pull this pillar trim, which means you have to pull this trim and this trim and this trim and this trim. Now you don't have to pull this trim, you just have to pull the screw out of it. Same with this one. Pull your floor trim. Junk. Let's see, 7/16 bolts go all the way through to the wheelhouse. Cracked panel, and the whole objective here is to try to remove this without cracking. And even though it's already cracked, you still want to learn how. So, get a mark here. All my places marked, and I know that this isn't 8.5 inches to there because I saw that on the other side. This one should be right here. You cannot push this up off of here when it's all dried and brittle like this, because it'll just bust right along that edge. So you saw the little barbs that are on there. They don't exactly line up with my marks, but it gives you an idea where the neighborhood is. See them where they are. That was a good panel over there, too. That really bummed me out. Oh, I see. Something I have not learned from that side yet. I'm saving that one. The lacing has to come off. Well, if you want to take this trim off, then you got to take this trim off. So when I said you don't have to remove this upper molding, I lied. When you get this one off, you got to take that one off. Well, you got to take the screw out anyway. Windlass. It's stapled in to a tack strip. And this windlass is actually in very good shape.
Everything on this car is in very good shape.
A shame.
Ooh, a screw.
It's coming out my hand. Almost looks like a seat's in the way too. Of course, the seat is in the way. Just that wee bit, Captain. Here we go. Now on this side, they've afforded you a little bit of access. On the other side, they did not. So I had to make my own. Now, I got my 12-inch Exum extension here, half-inch deep socket, and roll tape. Because my swivel is all loose and floppy, that's one reason to tape it. The other reason to tape it, because you don't want to drop your socket down in the abyss. Especially if you only have one. Now you can't see in here. The mail carrier comes. What's this? Well, it's a broken something. They speak in your language? Wiring harness. Socket. Nut. Okay, let's try the other one. Oh, no. Oh, good. It fell in a vertical position. Where's the other one? There it is.
cutting off ever so big a deal. Feels like it's off. It still doesn't do. So an hour later, you're rewarded with a taillight bevel. Now if it would just come unplugged.
We ain't out of the woods yet.
Wow. I see. One taillight housing, 1963 Buick Wagon, 63 and 64. In very, very nice shape, I might add. Okay. Hopefully that gives you guys a little bit of a fix for a while. And speaking of fix, I think I'm going to change Google's name to Scroogle, because, you know, I don't do Facebook, I don't do Twitter other than the business, and this whole thing now, if I don't answer your comments, it's because I can't, because Google has seen fit to make my own Google Plus account for me that I have no access to. And all of my comments, I must now have a Google Plus account, and I don't want a Google Plus account. So, who knows whether they're going to continue with their shenanigans or whether they're going to wise up and put things back to the way they were, because I don't know anybody that likes it. So anyway, for elderly iron, if you ever need to do a 63 Buick Wagon taillight housing, there's how you do it. And so for Debbie, when they do yours, this is how it's done. So for elderlyiron.com, I'm Jeff Bradshaw. Well, I guess I'll update you on the contest giveaway, or the giveaway contest, however you prefer. And our five responses have flooded in from all over North America with the answer to this question: what was the name written on the bow of the Titanic? The Music Man in Sylvania, Ohio, he writes and says, the SS Minnow. That's absolutely incorrect. Roman in Menlo Park, California, his answer is Freddy. Wrong. Mr. Robertson in Silver City, New Mexico, he writes and says, the Jeff Bradshaw rubber ducky. No. Bree in Knoxville, Tennessee, writes in and says, the good ship belly flop. Wrong, Bree. And the last one here is in an envelope.
Well, he's from Canada.
So Terry in New Brunswick writes and says, the Gump Express. Well, Terry, that's absolutely incorrect. So all of your names get thrown in the hat or the cement mixer or onto the floor. And if you would like to enter the contest, all you need to do is send a 3x5 card to RNRTOT, Post Office Box 302, Selma, Oregon, 97538, with the answer to this question: what was the name written on the bow of the Titanic? And from all the incorrect responses, we'll pick a winner at random, and you will receive the Automotive Shop textbook, high school textbook, from 1974. So, oh, and Kyle, out in North Carolina, you didn't send me a self-addressed stamped envelope, so you're going to be waiting a long time for them stickers unless you send me one. So, with all that being said and done, I'll get doing some editing here. I wasn't too pleased at all when I went to pull this one off and this panel broke. because that was a good panel. Kind of all sun-baked and brittle, but I found out why, because of the method of which they used to hold these things in here, those barbs. So what we're going to do now, is trip over this torsion bar. Let's not do that again. Well, it's getting to the point where every nut, bolt, and screw is becoming valuable on these things. Ooh.